When any crime which is serious in nature is planned, coordinated and conducted by people working together on a continuous basis and their motivation is financial gain, no matter not always but often, then it is called as organized crime. Organized criminal working together for a particular criminal activity or activities are called an organized crime group. Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Priya Sapaha and in this video we are going to discuss organized crime. Basically, it is an ongoing conspiratorial enterprise engaged in illicit activities as a means of generating income. The activities includes credit card fraud, gun running, illegal gambling, insurance fraud, kidnapping for ransom, narcotic trade, pornography, prostitution, racketing, smuggling, vehicle theft, etc. Some definitions of organized crime. In 1975, United Nations defines organized crime as a large-scale and complex criminal activities carried on by groups of persons, however loosely or tightly organized, for the enrichment of those participating and at the expenses of the community and its member. It is frequently accomplished through ruthless disregard of any law, including offenses against the person and frequently in connection with the political corruption. According to Paul Nesbitt, organized crime is any group having a corporate structure whose primary objective is to obtain money through illegal activities, often surviving on fear and corruption. Due to the advancements of science and technology, especially internet, and arrival of international terrorism, the picture and the type of organized crime has been changed and varied. Now, the organized crime covers practically every nation and segment of society and uses extremely sophisticated methods and credible front organizations in movement of large amounts of money and weaponry. Characteristics of organized crime. First one is continuity. The criminal group operates beyond the lifetime of individual members and is structured to survive changes in leadership. They are having a business of a pyramid-shaped hierarchy where it freely employs violence and bribery to maintain its operation, threats of grievance retribution to maintain internal and external control, and contribution to various illicit activities. Membership. The membership in core criminal group is restricted and based on common traits such as criminal background or common interest or ethnicity. The potential members are subjected to a lot of scrutiny and required to prove their worth and loyalty to the criminal group. The rules of membership includes secrecy, a willingness to commit any act for the group, and intent to protect the group. In return for loyalty, the member of a criminal group receives economic benefit, certain prestige, and protection from law enforcement. Criminality. The criminal group relies on continual criminal activities to generate income. Some activities such as supplying illegal goods and services. Violence. Violence and threat of violence are an integral part of criminal group. The violence or threat of it used against a member of the group to keep them in line, as also against the outsider to protect the economic interest of the group. Members are expected to commit, condone, or authorize violent acts. Power or profit goal. The members of this group aim to maximize the group's profit. The political power is achieved through the corruption of public officials, including legislator and political executives. The criminal group maintain power through its association with the protectors who defend the group and its profit. Thus, organized crime is different from unorganized crime on the basis of first, non-random nature of criminal behavior. Second, coordinated activities of hundreds or thousands of operatives. Third, diversification of activities like production, supply, retails. Then fourth, regional, national or transnational scale of operation. Then fifth, large volume of turnovers. It is running into billions of dollars in some cases. Sixth, pursuit of both power and profit. And lastly, usually an identifiable leadership. Now, categories of organized crime. The first one is organized predatory crime. Second is crime syndicate. Third is crime racket. And fourth is political graft. In organized predatory crime, the benefit is enjoyed completely by the gangster with no service or benefit to the victim. In this system, juvenile delinquents and occasional offenders turn into professional gangsters over the time. Professional criminal gangs require experience and careful planning than occasional criminals. This includes prior selection of spots as well as preparing escape from punishment in case of detection. For example, the type of crimes are theft, dacoity, extortion, kidnapping, pickpocketing, etc. Terrorism is a large form of an organized predatory crime. Next is crime syndicates, which refers to a criminal gang which offers an illegal or forbidden service to the desirous customers who are ready to pay handsomely. There is a market for illegal prohibited goods services. Unlike organized predatory crime, the victims get some goods or services for which he paid. These crime syndicates are having skilled and professional masterminds, and they are also protected by political organizations who have respectable position in the society, like businessmen, lawyers, politicians. Crime syndicate includes gambling, commercial prostitution, bootlegging, supply of narcotic drugs and intoxicants. Crime racket or racketing. It is a systematic extortion under some kind of threat, usually of personal injury or property. It is an illegal exploitation from some legitimate or illegitimate demand. It is different from organized crime due to the involvement of services, which is not completely predatory. It is also different from crime syndicates because the service is rendered to people who are normally engaged in legitimate business, while in syndicate the activity is totally illegitimate and prohibited. For example, business racket in which fictitious names are put in labor rolls and huge sums are drawn in their name and the expenses are shown on record. There are gambling rackets which lure people to put more and more money in horse races or game of chance and luck and then dupe them. Similarly, cyber casino and internet gambling have become modern forms of this crime. Political graft. It is the usage of notorious offenders by politicians so that they can come into power or get some benefit for their political party, such as giving victory in polls, etc. These offenders use both legitimate and illegitimate methods to get their master win. Problems in control efforts. The first one is inadequate legal structure. Secondly, difficulties in obtaining proof. Thirdly, lack of resources and training. Fourth, lack of coordination. Fifth, criminal, political and bureaucratic nexus. And lastly, dual criminalities. So that's all for today. I hope you liked the video, and if you like it, do not forget to hit the like button and subscribe my channel. Please do comment also, it motivates me. Thank you for watching. See you soon. Take care. Bye bye.